So recently, there was the presidential debate between Donald Trump and Joe Biden. And this week on Twitter, it has caused quite the firestorm. Basically, the left has been slowly acknowledging the fact that Biden is unfit to be president. And they've sort of been bracing themselves, preparing themselves for an anticipated future Trump victory because Biden is just so clearly incompetent. But Morning Joe Scarborough, king corporate Democrat in the flesh and the mouthpiece for the regime, has put in his two cents, and he said Biden is far beyond cogent. He's better than he has ever been intellectually, analytically. He is the best ever. And of course, no one believes that except people who have totally drunk the Kool-Aid.
But comparing that guy's mental state, I've said it for years now, he's cogent. But I undersold him when I said he was cogent. He's far beyond cogent. In fact, I think he's better than he's ever been intellectually, analytically, because he's been around for 50 years. And, you know, I don't know if people know this or not, Biden used to be a hothead. Sometimes that Irishman would get in front of the reasoning. Sometimes he would say things he didn't want to say. This is, and I don't really, you know what, I don't really care. Start your tape right now, because I'm about to tell you the truth. And F you if you can't handle the truth. This version of Biden, intellectually, analytically, is the best Biden ever.
No one believes that. No one believes that at all. This guy is lying through his teeth. And it's so funny that he's because of course Biden was on the super predator train along with Hillary back in the 90s, that he's now trying to act like oh, that Irishman, he could be a hothead. No. Biden was a blue dog, borderline Dixiecrat, because he's from Maryland or Delaware, basically right on the border of the Southland. And no one's buying this. He is clearly, I've seen people on hospice care. I've seen people on hospice, and they look like Biden right now. I remember flipping on that debate, and I'm like, he sounds sick. He sounds close to death. And I wasn't even happy either. It was tragic. It was downright tragic. Which brings us to this tweet. Will you still love me when I'm no longer young and beautiful? And we see a nice, young, handsome Biden there who looks like he's fit and ready to take on the world, contrasted with old, decrepit Biden here who looks sad, downcast, beaten down by the world, and honestly, quite a bit like the Crypt Keeper. Quite the difference between these two photos. And I and a lot of other people, I didn't even really feel like this was a win. You know? I can't believe I'm saying this. But I really felt like, how could they do this to my president? How could you do this to this old man? His end, like how awful it must be. What a Faustian bargain Biden must have made as a young man. To finally have become the president, the highlight, the pinnacle of his career, and he has to spend this entire time, a decrepit, senile old man, breaking down, barely functioning. You got to feel bad. There's a lot of pressure here. President of the United States, but is by far one of the hardest jobs. None of us tweebs could last a single day. I don't know. I could last longer than Biden is lasting right now. All of these special interest groups behind the scenes pulling the strings are doing the presidency for him. He's not really doing much himself. And it really does come down to a question of like, because there's a significant faction within the Democratic Party right now who wants another candidate. But obviously switching would leave a power vacuum because I don't know if they've had their convention yet and formally voted. But anyway, replacing him would still leave a power vacuum and there'd be a bunch of people vying for the position. And that decision has its own pitfalls. So the Democrats are really kind of screwed if they, you know, going forward, if they don't replace him. Obviously, he looks weak. Everyone thinks he looks weak. Nobody who's honest at all in the slightest thinks he's fit to run. But then on the other hand, if they replace him with someone who is clearly mentally competent, who clearly isn't senile, then that comes with its own pitfalls and challenges. To break away to Yahoo News here for a moment, Biden campaign argues president dropping out would lead to weeks of chaos. President Joe Biden's campaign on Saturday night, in a fundraising appeal to supporters, said the president dropping out would only lead to weeks of chaos and leave the eventual replacement weakened ahead of a November face-off with former President Donald Trump. Quote, the bedwetting brigade is calling for Joe Biden to drop out. That is the best possible way for Donald Trump to win and us to lose, end quote, Biden deputy campaign manager Rob Flaherty argued in the email to supporters. Quote, first of all, Joe Biden is going to be the Democratic nominee, period. End of story. Voters voted. He won, overwhelmingly, end quote. Trust the science, Flaherty added. Quote, and if he were to drop out, it would lead to weeks of chaos, internal food fighting, and a bunch of candidates who limp into a brutal floor fight at the convention, all while Donald Trump has time to speak to American voters uncontested, end quote. And the thing is, this guy is clearly a shill for Biden. He's the campaign manager, so what am I even saying? But he's clearly shilling for Biden, but then also what he's saying is true. Like, switching to another candidate is just going to confuse people. It's going to take the steam out of Democrats' momentum generally, and it's already bad, but there are compelling reasons that move would only make things worse for Democrats. Although donors are clearly furious that they're even considering this, given Biden's performance in the last debate. Like, anyone who has eyes to see and ears to hear knows that Biden is senile. Biden is busy quashing internal dissent, but his donors are not happy at all. That's what I gather from this article. He continued, quote, all of that would be in service of a nominee who would go into a general election in the weakest possible position with $0 in their bank account. You want a highway to losing? It's that, end quote. Got to agree, even though this guy's literally a Biden shill. Anyway, let's see what this tweeter has to say. Back to Twitter. This is actually insane. Imagine the decline after four more years.
I continue to think we have to make fundamental changes in civil rights. And those civil rights, by the way, include not just only African-Americans, but the LGBT community.
He wants to get away with and get rid of the ability of Medicare to
I did not oppose busing in America. What I opposed is busing ordered by the Department of Education. That's what I oppose.
Making sure that we're able to make every single solitary person eligible for what I've been able to do dealing with everything we have to do with,
you will determine the outcome of this election. Vote, vote, vote. If you're able to vote early in your state, vote early. If you're able to vote in person, vote in person. Vote whatever way is the best way for you, because he cannot stop you.
And I'm going to continue to move until we get the total ban on the total initiative relative to what we're going to do with more Border Patrol and more asylum officers.
President Trump?
I really don't know what he said at the end of that sentence. I don't think he knows what he said either. Look.
Oh, brutal. Brutal. Trump was not as fiery as I wanted him to be in this debate, but Biden is still clearly cooked, as the Zoomers say. Next tweet. Redditors are coping desperately. Reddit thinks CNN is right wing. CNN is Fox News light at this point. They desperately need a Trump to win. To keep the ratings up. Yeah, CNN's the, quote, I'm actually super conservative, but I don't like the dude with the horns from January 6th, end quote, channel. Redditors are freaking out. Redditors are all delusional, soy-swilling progressives. Now, I will agree that CNN is pivoting to the center, in a sense, but to call CNN right-wing is just a joke. Redditors are laughable. It can be argued that CNN is trying to shift to the middle to pick up some new viewers, but super conservative? Come on. These people are delusional. Redditors are completely insane.
You know, that's interesting because The Boys was trying to make a correlation with CNN being Republican-based because it was they had their equivalent VNN, which had the firecracker special on it.
Really? I don't know. Was that the one with the guy who's supposed to be Tucker Carlson on it? Because, no, that's clearly a Fox analog. That guy's clearly Tucker. Yeah, but I was
saying that there was also VNN, which is obviously
CNN. Well, The Boys generally is super cringe and super soy. It is like Redditor politics. I mean, it's really, The Boys is really like this Bush-era comic that, like, doesn't make any sense in this current political context because leftists clearly have the levers of social and cultural control. Like, America's not turning into some sort of totalitarian evangelical state. It's just nonsense. But anyways, next tweet. This is pretty funny. This is funny because Trump, like, never exercises and is super unhealthy, but is still doing better than Biden.
I think it is fair to say he is 3 years younger.
You think in 3 years he'll be exactly like Biden?
Well, Biden went downhill just from 2019 to 2024, so.
No. No. Wishful thinking from a never-Trumper.
No.
That's what you are. That's what you are. That's what you've always been.
Sure.
The cope on Reddit is insane. They can't accept that Biden is in mental decline. CNN slammed for Trump for letting Trump lie through entire debate. I think what happened was Biden was prepped on what Trump would say about issues. I don't think they prepped him on what happens if Trump just doesn't answer the question and talks about something else entirely, on top of Trump having his brain melt and not making much sense on stage. Biden was probably caught flat-footed trying to parse what the F he was hearing and trying to respond to it. Which, to be fair, Biden would still have done better. He missed a lot of key things for sure, but that tripped him. Over 700 updutes on that Reddit post. Can you believe these Redditors? I'm certain that Reddit is influenced by some alphabet agency, so I wouldn't be surprised if this were forced to the top or forced into prominence, but, like, really, you saw Biden, you saw him begin that debate, and he didn't think immediately, this man is sick and unwell. Complete lies. This person's saying, I'm not a conspiracy theorist, but, like, what the F? Why couldn't he talk like that during the debate? Probably because they got his cocktail of drugs wrong. Let's see what he's saying here.
Fire. Look, folks, what's going to happen over the next couple days is they're going to be out there fact-checking all the things he said. I can't think of one thing he said that was true. Oh, I'm not being facetious. But look, we're going to beat this guy. We need to beat this guy. And I need you in order to beat him. You're the people I'm running for.
I need you in order to be... Doesn't he sound sick and old here still? Still sounds weak. Still sounds terrible. The cringe, dark Brandon from the Biden-Harris HQ. Why couldn't he talk like that?
Who the hell is dark Brandon?
It's this meme they made of him to make him seem cool. Probably some Biden staffer who's our age has cooked up something, and that's what they came up with. Why
oh, you
could
mean him with, like, the fucking Homelander eyes and all that?
Yeah, exactly. You see it right here. This is now the official meme of the cool Biden supporters who are young people.
It's not cool.
Well, it never will be.
As a former leftist and as you being a former leftist, you know what the arguments always used to be a couple of years ago when Bernie Sanders was running? What? Was that he was too old.
Bernie Sanders seems more functional than Biden right now.
He's way more functional.
You're still a Bernie supporter deep down.
No, actually, I haven't heard much from him, to be honest. I wonder if he's going to retire soon.
He's busy enjoying his private jets.
Bernie?
Yeah.
I actually, have not seen clips of him. You know how they used to post them? I haven't really seen anything about him in a while.
Yeah, and they have, a Trump tweet from, or I don't even know what you call it, a Trump message from Truth Social as their background, supposed to be cool and fun, blah, blah, blah.
Just running on the anti-abortion issue.
Basically, yeah. Why couldn't he talk that way during the debate? Because they gave him the wrong cocktail of drugs. Please let that man run without a script. These must be Fed accounts that are posting this stuff. Base though, Biden is done. What, did they use the wrong clone for the debate? What's going on? I can't even believe. Suddenly when things aren't going their way, Democrats believe in the schizo clone theory, even though this is a joke. Come on, come on. Cringe. Cringe. Ugh, I hate this. Look at this blue wave account. Ugh, Democrats disgust me. Redditor calls for someone to save America by doing something to Trump. That's awful. We gotta, oh boy, Trump. There is no other choice left. We have to. There is just no other option. Otherwise, this country will die. I don't even want to go through this either. Redditors are insane. Redditors are evil and insane. Hopefully this was forwarded to the Secret Service. Redditors are dangerous. Leftists will never acknowledge how they radicalize people, but then you literally see stuff like this. They literally are we have to stop him through harm. Oh, awful. 2020, if Trump wins, I'm going to move to Canada. 2024, if Trump wins, I'm going to move to Canada. Asterisk. If Trump wins the presidential election, I'm going to end it all. Hearing about what's going on in the debate is making me sick. I feel like I'm about to vomit. If Trump wins, Project 2025 and whatever else Republicans have planned will be the death of me. I'm trans, queer, and disabled. If he wins, life for me is going to be a fate worse than death. So instead, I've decided that if he does win, I'm just going to end it all. I don't know how, I don't know when exactly, but I'm going to end it all if Democrats lose. My rights are hanging in the balance. What do you say? I know, this is morbid. My rights are hanging in the balance between two white men. One of them is pretty neutral about it, and the other one wants to wipe my kind off the face of the effing planet. He wants to genocide the queers. I can't effing take this S. The stress alone is making me think about ending it. All right here, right now. Only death can save me from this living nightmare. Man, how hard it is to be queer in this country at this moment. My friend told me about this. One of my friends said there will be a bunch of people who will want to self-delete if Trump gets reelected, because they just can't handle it. They feel their lives are staked on Democrats remaining in office, and it'll just be over for them. And this is really what Democrats want to turn your average leftist voter into. They basically threaten they threaten the general public with the prospect of another Republican presidency. That's really their strategy. That's really their Trump card, no pun intended, is they say, all these calamities will befall you if Republicans get back into office. They don't really promise anything that's really appealing to anybody. And all of their promises they do make, they don't follow through on. So they just kind of threaten the general public. Anyway, I don't know if this is legit, but what this says is breaking, the decision has been made that Biden will not seek re-election, according to Bill O'Reilly. O'Reilly says the White House doesn't yet know how or when to make the announcement. I don't know how trustworthy this is. It dropped very recently today. We'll see how things play out. And don't care, still voting for Trump is my position on this issue. In other news, the leader of North Korea, Just In has publicly executed. Oh, yeah. Majority of voters think Biden is cognitively unfit to serve as president poll. Poll finds 72% of registered voters doubt Biden's cognitive abilities. You'd have to be a lying through your teeth or a complete tool to not see this. He's totally cognitively unfit. The only people that would continue to support him are people who think that the cabal that's pulling the strings behind his back is doing a good job, or are just so vindictive that they don't want to see a Trump presidency. But anyways, this just in, North Korea has publicly executed 22-year-old man for listening to K-pop. Harsh but fair. I agree, harsh but fair. Do you think someone should die for listening to K-pop?
Ironically, yes, but actually no.
Okay. Well, anyway, someone has died for listening to K-pop. I kind of wonder what band he was listening into or why he... Because this is some, like, life-risking stuff, I guess, to have contraband from South Korea.
North Korean?
Yeah, he's a North Korean.
How did he even get access to that shit?
Well, he must have been smuggled in. He must have been really flagrant with it, too. That's how that must be how they caught him. I don't think this was worth it. I really don't. Anyway, on to the next tweet. When we take power, obese women will be arrested. What could this mean? Yeah, yeah. Okay. Well, let's go. Yeah. Oh, this is brutal. They're walking out without even seeing the full number. They don't even want to know how hefty they are. It keeps getting worse and worse. The first was like 250 something. Now we're at 314. This is just terrible. She said, baby, let's go. When I told her, I said, yeah, yeah. I got this has got to be the worst by far. 334. 335. Man. $3.14. She must like pie. Ha 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 ha. Math joke. This is terrible.
Ladies on the
man,
scale.
Man. Oh, boy. I don't even know what to say. There's a lot of weight. Heavy segment, right? Anyway, to round this segment of This Week on Twitter off, we have leftists reacting to various different red states making it mandatory reading for students to read the Bible. This is literally unconstitutional. Oklahoma orders all public schools to teach the Bible, effective immediately. Any teacher who refuses could lose their license. This based woman says, teaching content isn't forcing someone to practice a religion. Very true. The Bible is like a foundational text of Western civilization. Like, you can't hope to possibly understand European history and by extension American history if you don't know about the dominant religion which is influencing these two different civilizations. Of course, the goal of the leftists is not to actually illuminate and let the young folk understand the truth about the world, but rather to obfuscate, to make you think that as a young person, that we just sort of popped into existence after this awful European colonial empire that was trying to enslave the world, and that the natural state of man is some sort of ridiculous egalitarian utopia. But the Bible is obviously a foundational text. And I recall in one of my classes in college, back when I was in college, about how the professor was talking about how there used to be this sort of common fabric that society had. This was a liberal professor, and he still admitted this. Society had a common fabric, a common biblical understanding of things, and this had worn away. And the other students in my class who were leftists couldn't appreciate this because they'd never been used to anything like it, you know? There is just something so arrogant about the modern atheist, the modern atheistic leftist, who thinks you can just remove one of these foundational texts as though they're irrelevant and then have some sort of well-rounded or complete view of Western civilization. It's complete arrogance. It's complete ridiculousness. And these leftists can cope and seethe. I mean, what's cringe is that, of course, if they are pushing Christianity on these kids, it'll be some sort of cringe dispensationalist Baptist Christianity and not true Protestantism, true Presbyterian Protestantism. Still, this, having the Bible in school at all, is better than nothing. And of course, these leftist freaks want to prevent children from learning about it at all, even though, like, it's literally pivotal to you understanding how we even got to where we are. So, that's it for this week on Twitter. I hope you enjoyed this segment. If you didn't, there's going to be more of it, whether you like it or not. but anyways, please share this video, and Red Channels will catch you in the next one.